हेलो, आई एम रेशम एंड यू आर वॉचिंग डीएनपी इंडिया। सो पहले तो अगर आपने हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है देन प्लीज कर ले एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू शेयर दिस वीडियो एज वेल एज द अदर वीडियोस ऑन आवर चैनल। थैंक यू। सो अर्लियर इट वाज कम्युनिकेटेड दैट सीरियस कोविड-19 इन्फेक्शंस कुड डैमेज द ब्रेन कॉजिंग कॉम्प्लिकेशंस सच एज स्ट्रोक एंड डिमेंटिया लाइक सिम्टम्स एज पब्लिश इन द लैंसेट जनरल लास्ट ईयर एंड न्यूरोलॉजिस्ट हैव प्रीवियसली ऑल्सो वॉर्न्ड दैट कोविड-19 इज नॉट ओनली अ रेस्पिरेटरी इन्फेक्शन बट ऑल्सो टेक्स अ टोल ऑन द ब्रेन एज वेल एज द अदर ऑर्गन्स। And now, a new study from the UK, which studied brain scans before and after the infections, have found that there is a substantial loss of grey matter in those who have recovered from COVID-19. Yes. So first of all, let me tell you what exactly is the grey matter. So grey matter is vital for processing information in the brain, enabling individuals to control movement, memory, as well as emotions. So basically, it conducts, processes, and sends information to various parts of the body, linked to various functions such as memory formation, emotional response, as well as basic functions vital for survival such as heart rate, respiration, and digestion, and fully develops when a person reaches his or her 20s. So what exactly is this study? So the UK Biobank had scanned over 40,000 participants before the start of the COVID-19 pandemic. So this made it possible for the researchers to invite back in 2021 hundreds of previously imaged participants for a second imaging visit. Yes. And then they further studied the effects of the disease in the brain using multimodal data from 782 participants from the UK Biobank COVID-19 re-imaging studies, with 394 participants have tested positive for SARS-CoV-2 infections between their two scans. And the researchers then compared brain scans from the before and after COVID infection to determine the brain changes between these 394 COVID-19 patients and 388 controls, of course, the participants who did not get COVID. When the researchers identified significant effects of COVID in the brain with the loss of grey matter, while the team also compared 15 COVID-19 patients who had been hospitalized with those who were not. While the results were not significant, the team found a higher amount of grey matter loss in hospitalized patients. Yes. However, you also have to note that as this study is observational, researchers said that one cannot make claims of this disease causality with absolute certainty. That is, it is not necessary that the grey matter loss was caused by the COVID-19 infection. We do really need a foolproof confirmation on this, don't you think so? Respiratory system and now the brain? Things really need to be observed as well as studied now. So if you like today's segment, then please do like, share and subscribe to DNP India. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, and keep watching DNP India.